banking system is closely integrated with our day-to-day life. Whether we take cash from the ATM, or whether we pay our utility bills, or whether we aspire to buy a new house or a new car, banking system is everywhere. In addition to that, in financial press, there is always some amount of news that banks are doing good or banks are doing bad. You might be reading news about that there is an upsurge in the NPA of the banks, government is infusing capital. Now, this aspect is related to our course, Commercial Banking. We'll be discussing why the banks are important to the economy, what are the different types of banking structure, what is universal bank, what is retail bank, what is wholesale bank, what is unit banking, what is branch banking. In general, it is said that the financial statement of banks are very different from the financial statement of any other corporate entity. Why is that so? What are the assets of a bank? What are the liabilities of bank? How do banks make profit? Our course will discuss about this. Moreover, we will also discuss what happens when RBI changes the repo rate, how it is impacting you as a consumer, how the rates are changing with the change in the repo rate by the RBI. In addition to that, we will also be studying what is credit risk, in general how banks assess the credit risk of a borrower, how they quoted a particular amount of rate to a particular set of borrowers. In addition to that, we will also be discussing what are performing assets, what are non-performing assets, and how banks help in the trade process, and by helping them the trade process, how banks help the economy to grow. Lastly, we'll be discussing the payment and settlement process of the bank. Welcome to the Commercial Banking course.